do you want to learn how to code the Hangman game, but at a pace that you can understand? Here, we write the code for the Hangman game in our Fun and Games series. This video is designed so you can understand the code more easily. So we split the game up into four parts. We set up the game, the player guesses a letter, that letter's checked to see if it's in the answer or not, and also we show the hangman. So those four parts we're going to code, but we're going to code them in the order to make it easy to understand. So we're going to start off with the code where we show the hangman. Every time a person guesses wrong, we add to the hangman picture. So we can create a function called drawHangman. And in here, we do if-elif statements. So how many times the player guesses wrong, we can print what they've seen so far as the answer is, and also the hangman. So if they've got no guesses wrong, we just print what they've guessed so far. Whereas every time they get a wrong answer, we complete the hangman game. So we simply just copy and paste in the hangman code where we just print a hangman. So we start off with the empty hangman picture, and then we just copy and paste this, and then we'll put that in each statement, and then we can add the part of the hangman to the code. Now we've completed all of the hangman pictures, and as you see, we can go down, we have a potential 8 wrong answers, and you can see the finished board. When it's working correctly, you can see the hangman finished here, and we complete the game with hangman gave over if the user doesn't guess the answer. Now, there is a slight problem. If you look at the last two, where we have the hangman without the noose connected and with it connected, everything looks fine. But when we run the program, here we've just done a for loop for testing. We're going to run this program so we can see all the hangmans, and it says there's a problem. EOL while scanning string literal. And what it is this character is the escape character. That means it's telling Python that the next double quotes should be a double quote in the string. So what we need to do to print that slash, we need to use two of them together. So that tells us we actually want to print that slash in that string. Yeah, it seems confusing. But let's print it now. So now you can see it's printed all of the hangman from the beginning with the body, the arms, the legs, and then it finishes with the complete hangman and the guess and say game over. So that means that this code has been tested and that works. Now, here's the code for guess letter. So when we get the letter from the user, we just need to make sure their input is correct. So we check the letter and break when it is correct. So we need to loop. We only come out the loop when it's correct. And we can put a try and except to deal with bad input if you like. So I'm just going to paste the code in and explain each part. The first part checks to make sure the letter is not already guessed. So we have the guesses already. Here we use the vowels, for example. And if someone re-enters a letter they've already used, we get the error message. We need to make sure it's not numbers or punctuation. So we can use this letter dot is alpha to make sure it's a correct alphabetical letter. And finally, we need to check that it's only one character. So we can use length to check that it is only one letter. If a user puts in AA rather than A as an error, then that code will check that. So in our case, we're going to make all the letters lowercase. You need to make them either lowercase or uppercase to check with the answer. Okay, so that's that function working. Next, set up game. We've seen how we get a letter from the user. So now, how do we get a word or phrase from the player? Well, it's quite similar. We're going to use a while loop, try and accept. We can also use the isAlpha that we've seen already. Now, the slight difference here is we're allowing the player to put in a phrase. Now, a phrase can have spaces in, and they're not letters. So we need to check if the answer has a space in it, or more than one space. So you can see here the code. If a space is in the answer, what we do is we're going to create a temporary string, and that takes the spaces out, and then check to see if that is letters. So we're basically checking to see if the answer is all letters except for spaces, which is what we want. So we need to make sure the answer is in lowercase. So we can add that, put that in the right place. So when we have got an answer, we change it to either lower or uppercase. In our example, we're changing it to lowercase, and then we return that answer once we set it up. At the beginning of the game, the user is going to see just some dashes instead of the answer, and then they're going to guess each letter. So we're going to call that board, and we're going to create the board by using a loop. And in the answer, each character, if it's a space, we're going to add a space to the board, and if it's a plus, we're just going to add a dash to the board. So you can use an underscore, but it doesn't, with an underscore it just shows you a straight line. With dashes you can see how many there are. So that completes our setup function. Finally, check guess. We need to be able to change the board to add the letter when the player guesses it correctly. So here we've got a for loop going through each letter in the answer. Now, if that letter equals the guess that the player put in, we're just going to print it and the position that it's in. So I is the position in the answer. Now, the code that changes the board is this code here. So what this says is we want the board to equal the letter, the letters before then, before that position, which is I, and the letters after that position, which is I plus 1. So here, so for example, we've got the letter H. So that's going to be H plus all the dashes afterwards. There's nothing in front of it. If we change that to the letter O, then that will be the four dashes before it and nothing after it. And in the middle, it would be, say for example, the letter E. If we run that, you can see that before is one dash, so this equals one dash, and this part equals the three dashes after. So we can use this string slicing, and in the string slicing we have two parts, before and after the colon. If there's nothing in the before part, it means from the start. If there's nothing after the colon, it means to the end. So we have all the letters up to the position I, and all the letters from the letter plus one to the end. So if we try that, we can work, we can test it with the letter H. So we have here H and four dashes. We've tried E already. We can try L, because it's twice, we can see it's put it twice. And we finally try letter O, and yes, that gives us four dashes and O. So that's our code correctly tested. We finish with the final game. Let's put it all together. We've got our draw hangman function. We've got our get letter code. We've got our setup function. And when we check the guess, we're going to add one to the variable wrong that tells us how many guesses the user has got incorrectly, and how we play the game. So we set up, we've got empty guesses and no wrong answers. We're just going to use a for loop, and we're going to get the letter, add that into the guesses that we've the user's guessed already. We're going to check the guess to make sure we add to the board, and we're going to draw the hangman. So if someone gets the answer correctly, all the letters, we print, we win. And if we get to the end and the hangman's been drawn, there's 8 wrong answers, we also come out of the loop. So let's test that. So let's move this over and run. Let's put the guess into a story. So enter letter O. Okay, Y. T. Let's get some wrong. Okay, here's our board. You can see we're starting to build the hangman up. If we put a letter in, it says already used, try again. You can see with T as well. U, oh dear, we're getting close. I. So we're nearly ending. So we can try both if you want to see what happens when we get it correctly. We go, you win. So our game does work. You may want it so the user can say, right, I think I know the answer, and ask them to put it in. We'll leave you to code that and tell us your code in the comments. Thank you for watching, and if you'd like to help our channel, please like the video, share it on Twitter or recommend it on Facebook, and obviously if you haven't already, please subscribe.